Good morning, my brothers and sisters. Welcome to the English devotional, Good Morning Jesus. Today's biblical base comes from Luke chapter 6, verses 30 through 36. So says the Word of God. Give to everyone who asks, and if anyone takes what belongs to you, do not demand it back. Do unto others as you would have them do to you. If you love those who love you, what credit is that to you? Even sinners love those who love them. And if you do good to those who are good to you, what credit is that to you? Even sinners do that. And if you lend to those from whom you expect repayment, what credit is that to you? Even sinners lend to sinners, expecting to be repaid in full. But love your enemies, do good to them, and lend to them without expecting to get anything back. Then your reward will be great, and you will be children of the Most High, because He is kind to the ungrateful and wicked. Be merciful, just as your Father is merciful. Amen. When Mr. V.P. Menon first came to New Delhi, India, looking for government employment, all his belongings were stolen. He would have had to return home on foot and defeated, but in desperation, he went to an elderly Sikh, explained his problem, and borrowed 15 rupees to survive until he found employment. The Sikh gave him the money, and when Menon asked for his address to go pay him, he refused to give it to him. He told him that the help came from a stranger and that he should pay it forward to another stranger. Menon never forgot his debt and was even famous for his generosity. Not long ago, a woman was at the airport in Bombay in front of the baggage counter trying to retrieve her bags, but she had no Indian money left and the clerk accepted traveler's checks. At that, a stranger who was next to her paid the respective fees. When she asked how she could repay him, the man proceeded to tell her Menon's story. His father, he explained, had been Menon's assistant. If one of these simple actions makes us feel indebted to humanity, how much more the perfect gift of Jesus, who paid the ransom of all mankind. Whatever you want, Lord, for as long as you want. Amen. Giving to others when you have plenty to give is easy. Giving when somebody can repay you, that's easy. But giving and not expecting anything in return, or giving to those who cannot repay you, that is a testament of who you belong to. That is a testament of being like Christ. One story comes to mind that always resonates in me, and that story is of my mother-in-law. When my husband was growing up, they grew up very poor. They barely had enough food to eat. I remember stories of them sharing one or two eggs between three and four kids and his mom. So they were very poor. They lived very meagerly. But when my mother-in-law would get a donation of rice or beans or whatever it is, whatever food item she received as a donation, she would always set aside a part and take it and give it across the fence to their neighbor. And one day my husband asked him, "Mom, why are you giving them food when we don't have enough food?" He was very, very young, maybe 5 or 6 at the time. And she explained to him, "Because God will always provide for us, and they are hungry too. They need, so if we have some, we must always share what we have." The neighbors could never repay this back. But I bet you anything, those neighbor kids, they remembered this kind lady who always preached Christ, not with her mouth, not with her words, but with her life. That is being Christ-like. Christ gave us such of a huge gift that we could never repay. We are indebted to Him with a debt that we cannot repay. What a beautiful blessing that God has given us. So next time it comes to your mind to give of the little that you have or the great that you have, do it so knowing that Christ gave the ultimate gift, and that is salvation. Let's pray. Father God, I thank you, I praise you for the gift of salvation that you have given us. I glorify your holy name because the price that you paid is so great, we could never pay it back. Help us to live our life the way that you want us to live. Help us to reflect you. Help us to live with the spirit of generosity. Help us to give to those who cannot repay us, and give with a glad heart, with a joyful heart. Help us to imitate you in this area of our lives. Thank you, my God, for the gift of salvation. Thank you for your mercy and for your grace. These things I thank you and I bless your holy name. In Jesus' name, amen.
Oh, I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. I can hardly think as you call.